Lignin has challenged researchers and engineers for decades how to get higher value products from this complex fraction that has such potential.
Lignin chemists have been arguing about the exact lignin structure. So someone might say that it's actually not three-dimensional, it's like linear in the nature, but when you extract it from the pulping, then it reacts within the lignin and with the other lignin molecules and makes this three-dimensional structure. So actually, this argument has been going on in the lignin community for a very long time. So I think that if you can't even agree on the structure, that might be one reason why it's difficult to utilize.
So how can we overcome the messy structure of lignin? Monika Österberg has developed a method that literally goes around the problem, making lignin into nano-sized, evenly formed spheres.
You take the mess, you make the snowball, and then it's much easier to work with.
At Aalto University, Professor Österberg's team has successfully applied these nano-sized spheres in numerous applications.
To use in adhesives and composites, these kind of large-scale applications. But it also opens up totally new application areas that lignin haven't been used for, like drug delivery. We have also seen that it works very well as a dispersant and then like emulsion stabilizer.
Nanomaterials are usually very expensive to produce. However, these nanospheres are surprisingly easy and inexpensive to make.
The process is very cheap. So when we have calculated on the cost of the process, I think we are below €1 per kilo. So, and that's a lot of the cost comes from the lignin. So the process is actually just dissolving lignin and then precipitating it in water. And to get away from this antisolvent it doesn't like, it aggregates with each other, so they form the spheres. And so it's kind of a self-assembly. The lignin that is not soluble in water, it wants to avoid the water, and then it forms the spheres. I mean, if you go to nature, you're not going to find squares or stars. The sphere is the minimizing the surface area, very simply. So that's the form. That's why water droplets are also spherical and not square.